always it's like every race starts from the, that area, and it's like, if I make that, then it's gonna be easy.
So that's the way to Charles River.
Yep.
That's
where Charles River.
So all those boats, they want to go into pretty big.
Yeah. So there's the 4th of July. Fireworks. So you know, it's a river is full of boats. Full of boats.
Hopefully they've got plenty of time before fireworks tomorrow night.
The bridge closes at midday.
Yeah, that's probably true. It's gonna be super busy.
Yeah, I was running there this morning, so there were already 2-3 boats were there.
Yeah, waiting.
Yeah, waiting. Yeah, why not? Yeah. Hanging out. And
yeah, these guys, they have so much work to do, so they are gonna skip 4th of July. So.
That's bad.
So I grew up with a father who was like competing. So I kind of, I was probably 5 or 6 when I started to sail. We've got a small dinghies, and then my father sailed like boats like that size, a little bit bigger than that one. And he's 79, and he's still sailing. And he's way too senior for the class. It's like everyone else is like in our age. And he's still going. They're doing well, so he's still winning or coming in second or not. It's a small class.
And then Suvi and I, my wife, got our first boat when the kids were small. So we had a smaller one than this one, and then we sold it when we moved to the States, and then we decided that we wanted to have a boat at some point, and then COVID came, and then we decided that at some point is now.
No, she's a senior executive in the insurance company. She's plenty busy on her own. As we were talking about Constitution, so that's the oldest the active Navy ship.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So they take pride in keeping it in mint condition, and they turn around the ship a couple of times a year. They just did it some weeks ago.
It's so pleasant. It's not humid at all.
No, it's much nicer.
Yeah.
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 Is this part considered like clean water?
It used to be very contaminated, to be honest. Basically, all the kind of crap was more or less let into the sea. And then in the 80s, I think, they kind of made a big act of cleaning up this harbor. So today, it's actually kind of seen as rather clean. But they have this huge purification plant out there. And what they do is they kind of clean all the gray water, and then they have a huge pipe that goes way out in the ocean for the kind of these, when it's purified already. So they let out the purified water, they let that out, but not in the harbor, way out there. So this is one of the many boats that you can rent them, you're going to belong to the sailing clubs here. So that's what a lot of people do, you don't need to own a boat right here, you can also borrow for the day. Yeah. Yes, I know the they had sold the wooden kind of boat. Was that the one you went out with?
Yeah, it was part of it.
Yeah, yeah. I think my kids went out once. Yep. Yeah. Ah, yes, yep. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, Boston is quite unique as a US city that has actually an archipelago. So they have 11 islands here on site. And they are owned by the government these days, so you can actually visit the islands. Now, yes, some islands have inhabitants and some are kind of summer countries. But they have this kind of smoking out condition. But basically, they have forced the owners of the land to give it back. And then when you pass away, you can't pass it in the kind of forwarding environment. That's been a little bit of the deal.
How much wind we have, by the way?
It still doesn't work. So we hasn't been up in the mast. We have this wind sensor which is broken up there. I have these spare parts. And I refuse to go up there. My wife is very keen on going up there.
What's the boat's name?
Yeah, blue and white. Yes, blue and white. Yeah, I think she's more determined. Yeah.
I like the answer.
She probably is.
How many books do you read, Professor? Like one every week?
How many books?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, so kind of keep in mind that when you are a researcher, you kind of get to cover a lot of ground. How many books do I read? How many books do I flick through? That's going to be kind of the So I flick through a lot of books, but then do I really sincerely read? I read a book right now about Poland, and it's kind of Poland from way back when, and then it goes through different, it's got the same family through generations. And it's quite interesting. And that's really reading it. But then business books, they're kind of, the sad thing with business books or good thing, I don't know, is that they're quite, you can kind of, you know, but when you know the structure of business book, you can quite quickly get the gist of any book. But it has kind of the, especially US and Anglo-Saxon books overall, they have this, they have a little bit of theory, then they have a lot of cases. Yeah, and the cases, and the story is through the theory. And then European books can be, and Asian books can be much more complex in the framework, and it takes a lot of time to understand what they try to really kind of come.
In one of our
movie
class, we had, there was a very diverse class, so they gave a very academic paper to read, and everybody was like, we don't understand this.
Oh, is that the one that I read?
Yes, the one on the
And that's how I studied. It was way less Harvard Business Review, and it was much more rigorous in-depth research. And of course, the objective was to create science steered kind of master's students, and then PhD. So, of course, the Bishop University.
Yeah, that's really interesting.
Yes, so I just published a book chapter, which is a summary of that book. So I call it kind of about entrepreneurship. It's about creative activism. So we think about these large organizations, so many want to